Hey, it's Chris. This video is the start of a new series where I help you narrow down the best, the definitive thing in any given category for Apple users. And today, it's to-dos.
I just thought of a pun, but maybe it's just much to-do about nothing.
Today's gonna be pretty interesting because we're gonna check out the basics, of course, like which to-do app has the best input experience, but we're also gonna check out which app has the most unique feature or features. But before we get started, here are my rules for apps to even qualify for this little competition. Rule number one, all these apps need to have an iPhone, Apple Watch, and a Mac app. That's because there's plenty of really unique to-do apps that have some kind of really cool gimmick, but only exist on one platform. Rule number two, it has to be a dedicated to-do app. Rule number three, it should have something unique about it that helps to set it apart from the others. And rule number 3.5, it can't be ugly. Now, before we fully get into it, there's a few apps that I'm calling the honorable mentions that broke one of my rules, or multiple rules, and couldn't be included, but I figured they deserve a shout out anyways. The first honorable mention is MinimaList. This to-do app will let you hide a to-do list in a live wallpaper. But unfortunately, there's no Mac app. Slash is a Mac app that forces you to work on just one to-do at a time, and it has a seriously awesome design. Moleskine Actions, I'm not even gonna try to pronounce it right, looks very, very nice, but that subscription really bugs me. And then Microsoft wants to be a heavy hitter in this space, so they acquired Wunderlist and renamed it Microsoft To-Do, but there's no Apple Watch app. So now that you know who's been disqualified, let's go ahead and get to the actual contenders today. First up, Any.do, because your busy life deserves this. Second, we're checking out Todoist. Organize it all with Todoist. The third app is Todo V2, now with Touch ID and Touch Bar support. Ooh, the Mac people are drooling. And finally, Things, the award-winning personal task manager. All right, so Any.do. One thing that I really like about this right off the bat is the super just clean, minimal interface. There's not a lot of clutter. One thing I don't like though is that there's a calendar view. I know some people love that. They really like to combine everything. For me though, I just want to keep things siloed up and just dedicated to something. What's pretty cool though is there's that button in the top left you can punch and then zoom out to see all your lists. And it's also cool that you can tag stuff, but it's pretty lame that you need to unlock Any.do Premium for that. Come on. Okay, I like this. You can add some subtasks to the main task, so you can kind of develop a hierarchy. And it's cool, you can add notes or attachments as well. And there's a dedicated button for a grocery list, it looks like, which I don't like that. Oh, and there's a button that lets you plan your day. What's that all about? Wow, so it'll run through your to-dos for you one by one. You can say, do it today, do it later, I'm done with it, or delete it. Any.do on the watch, just pretty basic, lists your lists. I can go on all tasks, personal, Apple reminders, grocery list. I don't want a grocery list. So you can come in and check stuff off. You can come in and add stuff. Clean, basic, functional. Onto To-Do. And wow, when this pops up, I'm not gonna lie, it's not my personal favorite interface. It's busy, there's a lot going on. So you open it up and everything without a due date shows up and then tells you what list it's in. If I tap on an item, I can favorite it or give it a priority. Then on the left, we have some different views. So it has a calendar icon, but it doesn't look like a calendar view, which is good. It's just telling you what's due today, and then you can list your favorites, see what's scheduled, or check out everything you've already done. Oh wait, down at the bottom, there is a calendar view, and I'm sorry, whoever designed it, I don't really love the way that it looks anyways, even if I was into calendars. So when you go to add a task, there's a place where you can add some notes and some tags without having to pay extra for adding tags. And you can really quickly say, do it today, tomorrow, Friday, or pick a day. It is kind of nice. You can sort things by dates or tags, priorities, locations even. Like, I need to do this only when I'm at the office. Show me just the office stuff. That's cool. So right now I'm looking at Todo on the Apple Watch, and it's showing me there's two screens I can swipe between. Kind of an interesting interface. It's going to take me a couple taps to get into my information, except it does show me what's next. I'll swipe over. And then you get 5 icons. Really, I just wish that it would let me get right in and see my list. It's too many taps. Next up is Todoist. So the big macro view is that you can see your inbox today and the next 7 days. You can break things down by projects or labels, and then you can put a bunch of filters on there. Now the thing with this one is it can be super collaborative, and I know other ones can too, but if you want to just see what's assigned to you or assigned to other people, you can do that too. So if I pop into the inbox, I really like the layout here. Definitely one of the best interfaces so far. I can add a section. Ooh, section headers, that's nice. Search is really nice and easy to get to. And the add task screen is just super nice. Clean, minimal, just the basics, nothing ugly. You can add a date, you don't have to. Set a reminder, give it a comment. So Todoist on the wrist loads up straight to a today screen. I can just scroll through everything I've got. I like that. Get straight to the point, get down to business. Really easy to jump in and get a more detailed view of my tasks. And I can even reschedule them really easily right here. Now I don't see a button to add something, so I'm gonna try to deep press. Of course, there it is, add task and choose view. Oh, so you get view options, inbox, today, next 7 days, projects. That's a nice Apple Watch app. I like that a lot. The last app that we're gonna check out today is Things. And when you open it up, there's a quick find right at the top if you want to jump right into something and you don't wanna drill down through several menus. And then you can see all these buckets, inbox, today, upcoming, anytime, someday, logbook, and then your projects underneath that. Oh, this is cool. You can filter by tag. You can paste stuff in here. That's really nice, time saver. Now Things, they're trying to take this to the next level here. I can tap on the plus button and add a to-do, new project, or new area, or I can tap and hold and drag it to a specific area, and it will create a new project or to-do that way. So if I click on an item, then I can see notes. I can really, really simply reschedule it, tap on the calendar icon there, but there's no calendar, it's just telling me, reschedule. Easily add a tag. Oh, I can add a checklist underneath. That's really awesome. I can give it a priority. All right, Things on the Apple Watch. So I see that there's a today view, but it's not syncing my stuff yet. So hello, maybe it has some sync issues. Let me see if I can fix that. Come on. Well, it looks like it would be really nice once it gets loaded up, but it's not syncing. All right, so let me check these out on the App Store and just see if I can pick out some unique things that help distinguish them from the other apps. So I'm looking at Any.do here, and there's WhatsApp reminders support, that's cool. And you can connect Any.do with 1,500 apps, including Gmail, Google Calendar, Evernote. Who uses Evernote anymore? Outlook and Slack. Oh, but that's a premium feature. And they're advertising their grocery list. I don't want that, I don't wanna combine it. And if I do want a grocery list, then I'll just make it myself. And then you got your focus timer, which is a premium feature, so To-do. Let's see what is unique in here. Drag and drop support for iPads, that's not here, but if you're an iPad user, drag in images or PDFs right into To-do. Oh, now here's something that's pretty cool. You can pinch or zoom on the list to control how much information is shown for your task list. That's pretty cool. And a dedicated tags panel. Yeah. Todoist, let's dive in. What can we find that's unique about Todoist? Add tasks quickly, that's nice. You can do that other places. Oh, and it lets you track your habits and goals. So I really wanted a to-do app that was really just focused on to-dos, but if you did wanna add in some habit tracking and you didn't wanna do something like streaks, which I just mentioned in a recent video, which I love and use, then maybe you could do that here, that's unique. You can get Todoist Premium annually for $35.99 or monthly for $3.99. Now look, I'm subscriptioned out. So for me, that's gonna rule this right on out. Okay, last but not least, Things. What is unique about Things? The all new Things, although it's been all new for a little bit. Focus on what matters today. So your calendar events and to-dos together without showing me a calendar view. That's exactly how I like it. Oh, plan ahead. This I like. So you're in the upcoming events and it's the 9th and tomorrow's the 10th. And you can just take something and drag it out of the 9th and down into the 10th and it's rescheduled. I really like that. Organize your projects with headings. Now, it's not the only to-do app that lets you do that, but I really like that. Dark mode, it looks just as good in dark mode as it does in light mode, so. All right, so let me just try to pick a winner here to wrap things up. Like, one thing to recommend to you if you're just looking for a recommendation and you're not gonna do any extra research. Todoist is out of here. I just don't like the subscription. To-do, To-do, I just don't like the design, so I'm gonna rule that one out. Any.do, I really do like. But I don't need the grocery list just taking up a dedicated button space for me.
or the calendar view. I just don't need it. I think the winner for me is Things. And especially if I can get the Apple Watch app working perfectly, the design's unbeatable. Absolutely unbeatable. I love the functionality. It's my favorite out of this group, for sure. Let me rank the icons really quick. I like Any.do because it's really simple. Then Things, then To-Do, then Todoist. There's just something about that red-orange color. I just don't like it. So that's gonna do it for this video. Let me know a couple of things. Which app are you gonna go with? Or do you use something else totally, and why? Also, what do you think of this concept, this series? And what do you wanna see next? Please don't forget to check out our podcast. It's the Dailytekk After Party. Dailytekk, Dailytekk, After Party. Also, we're Dailytekk on Twitter, on Instagram, all over the place. So please come over and connect there too. Come say hey, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Later.